I was born in Uganda in 1950, and a year and a half later, I slipped out of bed one day and I collapsed on the floor. And my parents immediately thought, oh, that's polio.
It would be hard to imagine what a world without vaccines would be like.
It would really be quite horrible. There would be outbreaks of disease regularly all over the world.
I don't even think I'll be here in a world without a measles vaccine.
The true deep impact and the global impact of vaccines just can't be overestimated.
My grandmother, she used to tell a story about when they would hear the bells on a hearse going down the high street, a funeral. She said as children they would rush to their nursery window to see if there were white ribbons on the horses, which meant it was a child funeral. And they happened several times a week. It typically affected children. One of the names for polio was infantile paralysis.
It's quite difficult to imagine a world without vaccines. Life expectancy would be a lot lower. People would have to lock themselves away and only come out again when it was safe. And ironically, there would be such a demand to do something that vaccines would inevitably emerge.
Vaccines are likely the most important public health intervention of the last 100 years. They've saved over a billion lives.
With the rollout of vaccines, we have seen a massive reduction in child mortality in sub-Saharan Africa. I am born in the Gambia, and growing up there, I lost a brother to measles. To lose somebody at a very premature age from a disease preventable by vaccines is absolutely devastating. Vaccines can prevent cancer, and there are two cancer vaccines. With the rollout of the current malaria vaccine, we are expecting to see a reduction of 40% of malaria deaths.
You could bring a vaccine to people, but will they take it? Anti-vaccination fears have been around for over a century. We know from the 1850s, when Jenner first developed smallpox vaccine, there were actually quite a few protests. A lot of it was about civil rights and libertarian values. There were arguments saying that it was poisonous, that children who received a smallpox vaccine would develop bovine or cow-like traits. A lot of it was just a genuine knowledge void that a lot of people had in the 1850s that they still have today. So on the one hand, we have the really hardcore, adamant anti-vaccination groups, but a lot of people are actually in the middle. And I think what we need to do is just engage with people where they are and where they're talking and not discount their real concerns. People, you know, want to understand things. They want to be confident. They might be afraid of needles. We have to understand their context and where they're coming from and what are their past experiences with health and vaccines. We have to ensure that people understand it and they'll take it.
Having vaccines that people are not taking will not serve any good. It's vaccination that protects, not vaccines. In a world without vaccine, it will be a matter of economic status, where the children of the wealthy who have access to healthcare will be surviving. Vaccines are the only public health intervention that can bring equality. So women don't need to have 5-10 children just to see 3 of them grow to old age.
This isn't about just individual rights. When you take a vaccine, it's protecting yourself, it's protecting your family, and it's protecting your community.
It's not just a personal choice, it's a moral choice as well that affects other people.
It's impossible to emphasize how important vaccines are. And the reason that we don't often realize that they're important is that we've eradicated many of these diseases.
The idea that vaccines could be a victim of their own success, it's about taking things for granted, isn't it? And not looking behind what the privileges we have in the modern world are. And what makes it the modern world and makes it a safe place for most of us to be. And vaccines are absolutely at the heart of that, they're fundamental.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that, be sure to check out these videos next. And if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button and click the bell to get a notification each time we upload a new video.